basically just create our statement piece. Like get back to who we are individually, but not only that, but as a collective, really the first time that we've ever created something like this as the collective, and not worrying about the whole, you know, the Pantera, the Nothing Face, the Mudvayne, all that shit. It's like, you know, if it's got memories or a mindset of Mudvayne because of vocals or drums for Pantera or Damage Plan or guitars for Nothing Face and stuff like that. It's like, I was the mouthpiece of that band. He was the drummer of that band. He was the guitar player of that band. Yes, you're going to realize those similarities, but no matter what, unless you assemble those exact members of those bands, you're not going to have that band. You'll have elements. I mean, it's very emotionally driven. I mean, for sure, there's like I said, there's angst, there's anger, there's frustration, there's helplessness, there's you know, kind of deep-seated, you know, kind of heavy moments. Like, for instance, like a song like Moth is, you know, Moth to a Flame is like, whatever, yeah, cool, it's a cool lyric. No, it's an instinct. It's an animal instinct that we all have as human beings. It's like, this is not a good thing, this is not a good thing, this is not a good thing, this is going to be fucked up, this is going to suck, but I'm going to do it anyway. Because you're just drawn to something. You could be drawn to a person physically, sexually, whatever, and you know it's the wrong decision. You just know it, but you're like, live and learn, gonna fucking do it. I grew up around music. I was very fortunate that I have a mother that was young when she had me. So when I was old enough to get what was going on, she was still young. She was still being a kid kind of thing. I was always around, you know, Sabbath and the Eagles and Queen and Frampton and, you know, say any great band from the 70s, I was raised around them. You know what I mean? And then my grandparents, they played. My grandpa was a like mandolin player, like kind of a bluegrass player, a fiddle player, could play the fiddle. And they lived on a farm, and you know, I'd go to my grandmother's house on the weekends, and they would get together with friends and stuff like that, and pretty much have like barn dances, like, but like chicken picking, like fast, like, you know, like bluegrass. Wasn't like, you know, like tearing your beer country stuff, like up tempo square dance kind of music, where it was like, you know, getting after it, so to speak. And then so I always grew up around music, and But I was around it so much I didn't realize how much I appreciated it. It was kind of taken away from me. And then, you know, what do people get into music for? Generally imagery, you know what I mean? Like once you start coming of age and, you know, your teen years and stuff like that. What was I drawn to? Motley Crue, you know, leather and spikes and handcuffs and crazy ass hair and blood and, you know, obviously the music, but like I said, you know, that look, you know, it's like, holy shit, this is awesome. And, you know, so, you know, Too Fast for Love, Shout the Devil, two of my favorite records, and still love them, all of them my whole life, you know. It really kind of brought me back around to really, 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 really digging music. You know, Metallica, early Metallica, and then, you know, all the big four, Slayer, you know, Rain of Blood, and Haunting the Chapel, Hell Awaits, all that stuff, and Beyond, and Megadeth, Anthrax, you know, Testament, Death, Obituary, like, it just kept getting heavier and heavier and heavier, you know, and, you know, then Alice in Chains, out of nowhere, just fucking amazing singer, dark lyrics, you know, I love that shit, the kind of diminished kind of sound, that minor sound, the dark, haunting harmonies and stuff like that. And that just kind of like makes your hackles stand up like, this is awesome, you know. And I'm just attracted to bad shit. Moth to a Flame. That, and then, you know, Pantera. Fucking, you know, one of my all-time favorites. Like, bands that, like, all the bands that I really go back to now are like bands that fucking changed my life. My family is like my friends now, so to speak. My grandmother passed, and I'm still very close to her. You know what I mean? I miss her very much, but, you know, I feel like she's right with me. Just like Vinny, I know, feels like Dime's right with him. It's like you never lose somebody all the way. Just their vehicle wears out, you know, or so it's taken from them or something like that. But you don't lose the memories and stuff like that. I'm very fortunate to have, because I don't look at like the band fan connection as being fans. Like some, like really, I've got really great friends all over the world that are fans, so to speak, but I just look at them as friends. We're all sharing something, right? When we're on stage, where there's this circumvention of energy that's happening, and it's crescendoing and it's building, you know, so I don't take that for granted. I loved it. It was awesome. It was great. We had a great time. And you know, we walked out of there, you know, having been our, that was our first French performance, you know, for Hell Yeah. So talk about, you know, as like somebody said earlier, he's like, yeah, it's kind of a bummer, but it's kind of awesome. I'm like, it's pretty fucking awesome. You know, that was the first time we got to come over here and service the whole French community. You know what I mean? It's awesome. It's awesome to be able to go around the world and share that moment with fans, because I do believe that we are a metal community, and it's worldwide, and it's awesome. It's really no other kind of music that really embraces each other's personalities, you know, as metal. I drink a lot. Unfortunately, man, when I'm home, I'm a wreck because I have no schedule. You know what I mean? Music is weird. It's like playing in a touring band is actually discipline for me, because I'm the singer, so I can't just like destroy my voice all night and then get up the next day and be like, how you guys doing? You know what I mean? Like, I take some pride in what I do. So there is a level of discipline when I'm on the road to like kind of keep it tamed down. But shit, I go home and it goes off the fucking rails, you know? Yes, I don't, yeah, I drink a lot.